Hi and welcome to my channel, my name is Magnus and today I'm going to show you how to export the interface configuration and the route configuration from a VS within a VSX system. So I have prepared a bit here on VS02. So we see here that we have two interfaces, not really a lot. One standard interface and one warp link, and then we have a few routes. We have one default route and we have one that is pointing to a virtual switch. And then we have a few static routes. Not really a lot, so I mean, this one you could potentially do manually, but let's say you have, I don't know, 50 interfaces and you have 200 routes. Then you don't really want to do this manually. So how can you do it? So one way would be to go into the CLI. So this is the expert mode. And then we do, first of all, we need to change to the virtual system itself. So we do VSX stat minus V to figure out which ID does this virtual system have. And we were working on VS02. So that's VS and ID number 3. See here. So enter. Now we can do IF config. And we can see the Ethernet 4 and we can see the warp link. So that's okay. But this doesn't really show like a list that you can easily copy and paste into a different checkpoint device, so you can, well, create a new virtual system in a different VSX cluster. And yes, you can see the routes as well. So you can do netstat minus rn. So yes, you can copy paste it. Not really efficient. And I just want to show this. If you go into Clish, so this is Clish, and you do show configuration. When you do show configuration, this will be on the VS0. So you see the routes is not even present here. And you see here that the colon 0, that means virtual system 0. So we need to do set virtual system, and then we need to do the ID number, and that would be 3. So if we do the same command, show configuration, we can see here, yeah, we have the routes. They're correct. But, and this is a big but, the interfaces, are they correct? So if we check for Ethernet 4, because we didn't have Ethernet 4, so we have 169 address. That's not the correct IP address. This should have 10.10.10.1. And this IP address that is shown within a shown configuration, if we scroll up here quite a lot, it's not the same as here. So this IP addresses that are shown within the interface list, they are the internal communication IP addresses that VSX get. So that would be an issue if you have like 50 interfaces. So a different way to do this is to use VSX provisioning. And VSX provisioning, you're running from the management station itself. And we are running an MDS. So we do MDS stat. And we see we have multiple different CMAs. And this specific VS, it's located within the SEC002 CMA. Because the VSX provisioning, you need to run this from the management station and you need to specify which specific CMA is this virtual device included in. If you're running a normal SMS, normal management gateway, you don't need to point out a specific server, then you can point to localhost or whatever. But let's do VSX and then underscore provisioning tool, and we can do dash H for help. And then we can see all the different types that we can do here. So it's quite a lot. And we are looking for something like show. And so this would be the command. So show virtual device name and then virtual device name. Because the virtual system is a virtual device. A virtual switch is also a virtual device. And you can get configuration from a virtual system, from a virtual device or whatever. So you can get from multiple different things. Of course, you can also create gateways, you can also add routes and so on. So this is the CLI way to be able to, well, do changes on a VS. But we will do this show virtual device name. So if we scroll down, we will do VSX provisioning, and we will do minus S, because this will point to the specific server. And then we will take this one. So copy. And then paste. And we will do minus O, because this is what you're using to send commands. It's also standing somewhere here. Execute commands provided on the command line. So we're using this O. And this is the syntax that you need to be familiar with. You can, of course, find this within an SK or the admin guide, I guess. Maybe I have one. So if you're searching for VSX provisioning within the admin guide, you will see this. So VSX provisioning tool, it will say the same. And it will give you some few examples. But we will do this VSX provisioning tool, then minus S for the specific server, minus O for the command that we want to run. And we will do the show virtual device name. So this. Show virtual device name, and then VS02, because that's the name the virtual system has. You should not open this one, because it will log in and actually lock this object. I don't know if we can maybe do like this so we can see the little, lock here. So virtual device name. Let's see. And then you need to provide the username and password for the admin that can do this command. Error, that's not good. Let's see. Was it the correct IP? Authentication failure. Yeah, okay. It's good to write the password correctly. But here you can see. So here it begins. So this is the complete configuration for this virtual device, this virtual system. So it says that it has this name, it's on VSX, and it's on this specific cluster. It has this main IP address. We can see this here. Let's have so we can see it at the same time. It has one interface called Ethernet 4, and it has a different interface that leads to, and this is a virtual switch, and then it has an IP address, and it has got a generic name. So you see it's a little bracket here. That means if you send this into VSX provisioning tool again, it will not include this, because this will be a generic auto-generated name. And then we see the specific routes that we have here as well. So this is quite nice. So this is how I would take out the configuration in a quite easy way when it comes to VSX. And this is also why it's so important to have a backup of your management station when you're working with VSX, because all the configuration is actually on the management station, and then it's pushed out to the VSX system. So if you're working with VSX, or if you're planning to implement VSX, you should try the VSX provisioning tool out. It's really efficient. It's a really good way to make large bulk changes, because currently, as of June 2022, there is no API for adding like routes and so on within a VSX and a VS. So the APIs is lacking a lot when it comes to VSX. So use VSX provisioning tool. And I think that's it for this video. And I hope to see you next month. Take care. Bye.